您好，欢迎收看中央社全球视野，我是黄家华。菲律宾仙宾礁发现大量倾倒的珊瑚残骸，菲律宾海岸防卫队表示，中国疑似在南海进行填海造陆。由于距离菲律宾巴拉望省只有71海里，菲国计划部署大型的海巡舰监控阻止中国的造陆行动。潜入海底，映入眼帘的是一片倾倒的珊瑚残骸。菲律宾海岸防卫队发现后，立即在仙宾礁部署97公尺多功能巡逻舰“马格巴努亚号”，并展开至今已经28天的调查。这也是菲律宾海防船只在西菲律宾海部署时间最长的一次。菲律宾自5月7号以来，监控到44艘中国船舰，包括海上科研船、海警船、海上民兵船、海军舰艇和3架军机，并发现12处被倾倒的死珊瑚或珊瑚碎石。
There are now dump corals, because last year there were no dump corals that we noticed. So this is the most alarming part of our findings.
在沙滩上随手一挖都是珊瑚残骸。西菲律宾海是菲国主张在南海拥有主权的区域，大致为菲律宾200海里专属经济海域范围。海岸防卫队指出，根据近期菲国学者的调查报告，菲律宾指控中方疑似在南海进行填海造陆。
The Chinese have already established a naval base through the Mischief Reef, and then in between Mischief Reef and Sabina Shoal.Is already a UN show. If the Chinese will be very successful in carrying out this kind of reclamation and then converting this once again to another naval base or something, it will be very difficult for the armed forces of the Philippines and the Philippine Coast Guard to do the resupply mission because they have already encircled the entire UN show. The commandant for the Philippine Coast Guard has to make sure.That we're not going to allow China from carrying out a successful reclamation in Sabina Shoal.
为防止中方填海造陆，菲律宾海岸防卫队将持续在仙宾礁部署大型海巡舰，并与菲律宾大学专家合作，记录并搜集中国船只活动及科学证据，以采取进一步的法律和外交行动。中央社记者陈彦君，马尼拉报道。印度自4月19号起举行为期6周的国会下议院选举，许多地方政府举办活动，宣导选民投票意识。在首都德里西北行政区举办竞走活动，鼓励选民在投票日当天尽早出门投票。
民众参加竞走，高呼出门投票。印度下议院选举自4月19号登场，首都德里投票日定在5月25号，西北行政区近日特别举办宣传活动。
Our walkathon has been organized to create awareness among the voters of India to cast their vote in a free and fair manner. So this is to create awareness that people do vote andcontribute towards a healthy democracy.
It is like a festival for us. 25th May is a festival for us. It's a festival of democracy. Everybody should vote. We should have our breakfast afterward.But we should vote first.
唤起选民投票意识，活动吸引数百人共襄盛举。现场还有青年人演出舞台剧，号召年轻族群踊跃参与民主。
So we have our team here. You know, since youth plays a crucial role in the development of the country, so we are here in helping out with the administration, with the whole program, and you know, managing people.
I am very excited to cast my vote first time. Choose our future leaders, so I'm very much excited for that.
由于印度合格选民多达9亿7千万人，因此此次选举在6周内分成7个梯次举行，结果预计在6月初统一公布。中央社记者林行健德里报道。
在海外，中央社拥有阵容最坚强的新闻团队，全球布局居台�湾媒体之首。将近30个据点分布5大洲，以台湾观点掌握全球脉动。端午佳节将至，除了我们熟知的粽子、龙舟还有立蛋等传统习俗外，美国台裔青年文化大使设计了一款名为《川木鸡钻林里》的游戏，将台湾的端午节故事带入华府。
说到端午节，你会想到什么呢？是粽子、龙舟还是立蛋？侨委会海外青年文化大使与台湾放在华府儿童博物馆庆祝亚太裔美国人传统月之际，发想一项游戏“穿木屐钻林里”，分享鲜为人知的端午节故事。
According to legend, there's a golden pangolin living underground in Taichung, and since Taichung was primarily an agricultural area in the past, the pangolin would help turn the soil. As the pangolin hibernates during the Dragon Boat Festival, if the pangolin is not seen moving, residents would make noise by banging pots and pans, stomping on the ground with wooden clogs in order to wake up the sleepy pangolin. Basically, we wanted to show off the uniqueness of this culture, and I think using three clogs lets like kids think of it as a game so they can work together and do it together.
考验亲子默契，探索传统文化与故事，动手扭一扭，认识木屐制作原理。游戏发起人希望借此打开台湾能见度。
We provide activities and like learning opportunities to learn about Taiwan because we feel Taiwan is sort of an underrepresented country. Even small things like bubble tea, which is becoming really popular in America right now. People think it's like a Japanese or like a Chinese thing, the chips in your computer. Like over like half of them are produced in Taiwan. These small things that people don't know just really like brings them, like opens up their mind to like the impact Taiwan really has on America.
一年一度的亚太裔美国人传统月，儿童博物馆聚集了许多亚太裔移民共同庆祝，包含南韩、日本、寮国、柬埔寨、菲律宾、印度、越南、中国等等。
We celebrate different heritage months and different celebrations that are part of our priority audiences. We will not be able to do any of these celebrations without the communities that we want to honor and celebrate here because we are all together in this.
侨委会自2011年起，在美国、加拿大等地创立由14岁以上青年加入的海外青年文化大使计划。青年大使和台湾放经常举办各式活动，让移民后代认识正港台湾文化，并协助推动公众外交，增进国际社会对台湾的认识。中央社记者石秀娟，华盛顿报道。
感谢你的收看，我们在华视频道及中央社网站都有播出。我是黄嘉华，我们再会。